Well, today, Sara Hagerty is a happy wife and mother of five, but for 10 years, Sara struggled with setback after setback and disappointment after disappointment. Take a look.
When Sara and Nate Hagerty were married in 2001, they looked forward to starting a family. A few years later, Sara found out she couldn't have children. In 2009, the couple decided to adopt. First, two children from Ethiopia. Then, 2 years later, two from Uganda. In her book, Every Bitter Thing is Sweet, Sara shares about how her personal setbacks transformed her life into a hope-filled journey.
Please welcome to the 700 Club, Sara Hagerty. Sara, it's
Thank
so good
you.
To have you
Thank
with
you
us.
For having me here.
Wonderful book. You really share from the heart the deep things that you felt. And really from the very beginning of your married life, as much as you loved God and you and Nate had known each other for a long time and served the Lord with gladness, there was an emptiness inside of you. Talk about that sense of disappointment and longing.
There was. You know, early in our marriage, we both had a passion for non-believers coming to know Jesus. And we were in full-time ministry together and running hard and sharing the gospel. And within a month after we were married, each of us independently, we didn't realize this until later, prayed a prayer where we said, God, there has to be more of you than what we're experiencing. We were nurturing the souls of others, but on the inside, we were bone dry.
Boy, that's so easy for Christians to do, isn't
it?
We perform for God's love.
Mm-hmm.
How did you come to the realization? I guess that's what the whole book is about.
Mm-hmm.
but you went through crisis after crisis. You had financial crisis that you went through. I mean, that would have leveled a lot of people. How did you survive that?
Well, what we began to see after we prayed that prayer and had to face some of these challenges, we began to see that pain really is an invitation and that pain is an opportunity. And that the verse where the title of my book is Every Bitter Thing is Sweet, and it's from Proverbs 27:7 that says, the satiated soul loathes the honeycomb, but to the hungry soul, every bitter thing is sweet. And when I first read that verse, I thought, at that point in time, we were really in the throes of kind of the bitterness of our lives, and I was getting hardened on the inside. And I read that verse, and for the first time, I thought, this is an opportunity. I can find God here.
Yeah.
I can be hungry and find the sweetness of him here.
And yet you were doing so many things that I think most Christian things people think are finding God, being with him. I mean, you were doing your devotions. You were involved in outreach to others. You were studying the word. What was the element that was missing that you finally found?
You know, I think it was the intimate conversation with God. I think it was opening up the barest parts of my heart before him and having him speak to those parts of my heart.
And maybe not being afraid of what his answer was going to be.
Exactly.
Yeah, sometimes the answer's no.
Mm-hmm.
How did you deal with that?
Well, again, pain for us was an invitation. Delay, specifically with my infertility, it was an opportunity to see that God had words for me when everything else felt dark.
Yeah,
he had sweetness of just God, just me and God for that moment.
And there was also, I think, in that what it takes so many of us so long to see the far bigger picture, that God had an answer for other children.
Yes.
At the same time that he had, it was answering your prayer in a very unique way, maybe not the way you expected.
Exactly.
Talk about that.
Well, we always had a heart for adoption. Even early on in our marriage, we thought we want to adopt one day. We had no idea that we would do it before we had biological children.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time that we were experiencing brokenness in our external lives, we had children who were living on the other side of the world, whose lives in some ways had been shattered.
And
God was saying, I'm going to marry these two stories and I'm going to show redemption to both of you.
Yeah. The miracle of it, I think, produces a wonder in you. And yet, the barrenness that you were experiencing at that time was a barrenness of the soul as well, even after your children came from the other side of the world two times.
Yes.
You still had an emptiness inside of you. How did you deal with that? Because you saw God's picture. You knew his hand was there.
That's a great question. You know, it was a struggle to know God is healer and he can heal, and yet he wasn't healing me.
Yeah.
And for me, it was hanging on to hope.
Yeah.
Hope is very awkward and uncomfortable. And we, in many ways, we want to skirt it in our lives because it is so, to stay at that place where we go, God, you're sovereign, but you also want me to keep asking you.
Yeah.
But hope is what leaves us vulnerable before him and invites that conversation with him.
And then God asked you a question in the middle of that. Will you still love me?
Yes.
If my answer is no.
Yes. It was one of the most profound moments in my life. I was sitting in church and I saw before me the picture of the cross with the word family nailed to it. And I felt like God said to me, if you never have a family, will you love me? And it took me days to respond. But up from within my heart came this cry, oh, you're that good. Yeah. I will still love you.
Yeah. It's an amazing book, and I think it speaks to the need in every person's life. We all have areas of our lives that are bitter or unfulfilled, times when we question God and what his plan for us is. I really highly recommend this book. Sara's book is called Every Bitter Thing is Sweet. It's an opportunity for growth. Don't miss it. This book is available wherever books are sold. Sara, thank you.
Thank you, Terry.
Wonderful.